Chris has said, if I raise my ignition timing 2 degrees for 93 octane, can I raise it 4 degrees for E85? No, I don't have a knock monitor. Okay, there is no rule of thumb that I can give you there. I know that this is probably a bit of an older one. There was a theory that if we took a pump gas timing map and we went to E85, then all we needed to do was add 10 degrees of timing, and that's simply not the case. What we need to do with our timing when we move from pump fuel to E85 is very dependent on how heavily knock limited the engine was on pump fuel. Now, an often overlooked aspect here is that the flame front speed for E85 is actually faster than for gasoline. So what this means is, all things being equal, E85 actually burns faster, the combustion process is faster. So if we're operating in a non-knock limited area of the map, we will actually need to retard the timing as we move from pump gas to E85 in order to achieve MBT. That's an aspect that so many tuners just don't understand or completely overlook. When we move into, particularly a turbocharged engine, we move into positive boost pressure. This is an area where we're most often going to find that we are knock limited on pump fuel, particularly at higher boost levels, and this is where E85 really comes into its own. This is where we now can use the properties of E85 to allow us to advance the timing. More often than not, we can advance the timing to achieve MBT. And here, it really depends how heavily knock limited we were. It's not uncommon in the positive boost areas of the map to be adding 10 degrees, maybe sometimes more. So we really need to use the dyno to help guide us with that. Personally, I won't tune an engine without some way of monitoring for knock, regardless whether I'm using pump, gasoline, or E85. If you want to know more about EFI tuning, click the link in the video description to take our free 6-part series of lessons that will show you the fundamentals behind EFI tuning.